Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look at Spring Boot and the virtual machine options. I was asked, is it possible to add more than one virtual machine option? And of course, the short answer is just yes. But the question was also, how do we set those Java virtual machine options? And it's pretty easy. We just press the edit configuration up here, and then we can add all the options we want on the VM options right here. And I've already prepared one run configuration right here. So right now here, I want to show the code details and exception messages. That means that the null point exceptions in Java 14 and ahead, they will then show more detailed null point exceptions when those occur. So that is one Java virtual machine option, which is right there. And I have another one that is the stack size that I'm adding, that I'm increasing to 10 megabyte. The default is 1 megabyte, and I'll show you the difference just in a minute. There's another cool feature that is you can actually create folders, and then you can organize your run configurations a little bit better. Maybe this could be some kind of environment. This could be your integration environment, and we just name this integration. I see it rarely used, but I think it's a very cool feature nevertheless. Also to give them a good name right up here, and you can actually store them as project files. I've ticked this one off right now. You can see per default they will end in the .idea folder, but you can actually just choose your own folder. You can just say this should be out in the root if you want to. Then say you want your run configurations out here instead, so then you press OK. Now I have run configurations right here, and then I got the XML representation of my run configuration right here. So and right here you can see the name is right there. There's no VM arguments on this one, so let us just try to also save the other one with the VM args, store as project file. Yes, again, remove the .idea, just want it out in root, press done. And okay. And now I also got the other file right here. And that means that now my colleagues can actually, if I check this into Git, my colleagues can then use the same run configurations as I have set up. Sometimes it's very difficult actually to set these up. We need to maybe apply 3 or 4 profiles in Spring for it to work in a local development environment. It depends on how you're using the profiles. Some developers actually choose to use the profiles in a pretty advanced way. So we continue applying configuration and continue adding profiles. If you want to use a MongoDB, then we just apply the Mongo profile. If you want to use MySQL, then it's a MySQL profile, etc. And if you want to add some mocking, then maybe it's the local development mocking profile we also want to add, right? So it can be quite complex actually to set up these run configurations, especially if let's say whether we have an application that uses a bit more memory than the default setup. Then of course we also need to set this up in the VM parameters right here, and you can see it's actually saved right there. We have the show code details and exception messages here, and then we have the memory limits for the stack set up to 10 megabyte. That's also the profile area where we can set up the active profiles. They are down here, so we can also set up some active profile defaults. Okay, now we can see that we also got an active profiles default section right here. So that's it. But let us. I have prepared some code that can actually ruin our application. And this is just to first of all, I would like to show you the null point exceptions so first. Then we can see it with two different run configurations. I have created this null point exception service right here, and the idea of the service is that it actually creates null point exceptions on startup, and then that means that the server will actually stop because it gets this error. So the whole server actually it never comes up to run, but we get a nice error message when we have one configuration. Let us just see the one. You can also see the when you're using the folders, you also get the folder structure right here. You get the organization up here also. Let us try to run the demo app without any VM arguments, and let us see how it looks. Now we have a null point exception, error, waiting bean, blah, 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 exception, and we do not get any help. It does not tell us that where in our object hierarchy we are. Now, I know this is a string, so there's not a long, a huge object hierarchy, but think about it. If you had a space station and then a spaceship and then a cargo place on the spaceship, and then you try to maybe count the number of carrots in the cargo bay inside the spaceship, then you would not know if is it the space station that was null, was it the was it the spaceship? Was it the cargo space that was null, or what was null here? And we cannot see this from this exception right here. We can actually not see what is null. Of course, we can see the line. Of course, we can click us to the line, and then we can see which line it was down here in the bottom. Then we can see that it was this line that the null point exception actually happened. But now let us try to use with VM arcs where we actually get a better null point exception. Then we can actually see what is that is null. It actually says it right here. Cannot invoke string.uppercase because s is null. So we are not in any doubt that it is the string that is null right here. And if you were dealing with the object arc here I just mentioned before, then we would just be told that it was actually the space station which was null. So it didn't care. It didn't matter about the spaceship. We do not need to debug in spaceship. We do not need to debug in a cargo space or anything like that. It was the space station that was null. It will write it like that and clear text, and it will save us some time with boring debugging. So that is really good. Of course, it's one of the arguments I added. I'll comment this line right now so we don't get the exception. The other thing I've prepared is let us just try to set it to the default without any virtual machine arguments. And then I have created the Stack Overflow service. The purpose of this service is to create a Stack Overflow exception. That means that I have creating this. I've created this other method right here, and this other method it actually calls itself. It continues to call itself infinitely, and that means that then at some point, then the call stack will be full, and then we will get an exception. I've created another video about the Stack Overflow exception if you're interested in depth of how this actually works. But there is actually we have a stack, and then every time we call a new method, then we will add then that is added to the stack, and then at some point that stack is full, and then it overflows, and that is why we get the Stack Overflow exception. But let us try to run first without any VM arguments, and let's just scroll up a bit. And you can actually see right here we end up at around how many iterations or how many? Yes, we have 4,810 iterations, and then we end up with the Stack Overflow exception right here. Let me just here we got it. Stack Overflow error. It's the right name. So let us try where now that we increase the stack size from 1 megabyte to 10 megabyte, and it's time configuration. Yeah, let's run that. Press play again. And instead of just having 4,000, now we are up at 50,000 instead. So this is ten times as many calls, and that is of course also kind of what we expected when we multiplied the memory size for the stack with 10. So I hope I answered the original question from the person in the comments, was how do we apply multiple virtual machine options. I hope I answered this, or else let me know in the comments. As usual, thank you very much for commenting and all that. Another thing, that is, have a nice evening. Hope to see you again soon, and bye-bye.